What's up, people?
Brian. Are you on mute?
So first of all, let me just start by saying I'm delighted to hear Daniel Levy has been storming into the changing room because all of a sudden his Champions League money has gone. I can't wait till Thursday night because I'm going to be storming into my seat to tell him exactly what I think of this prick. Exactly what I think of what he's done to this team. Exactly what he's done to this club. This spineless, gutless, toothless club. From the very top to the very bottom. Anyone that tries to find a positive, a reason to say, oh, this isn't down to Levy, this is a... Do me a favour, I'm done now. I'm done. Playing games is... It's over. I don't care what you think of me. I don't care how you receive me. I will fight with the people I fight with until this guy is so far away from this club that we can try and get a sense of belief and pride and passion and desire in this club. That was one of the... I mean, I was pissed off last week with Bournemouth. I mean, guys, I feel so sorry for you having to do this. I know just how hard sitting in those seats that you do. The people that went there, I feel very, very sorry for. And if Tottenham Hotspur don't refund every single one of those people's tickets, then they're more of a disgrace than I ever thought was possible. But you guys have to sit there and commentate and put on content for the thousands of people watching where you you have to put yourself through that part as well. So full credit to you and both of you. We are just the biggest disgrace and banter club I've ever seen. And everything that comes our way, we absolutely deserve it.
What was your reaction when you saw the lineup initially, Brian?
Well, I would say the truth, mate. When I first heard the lineup, I looked at my app and I've got... everyone's got their own like kind of apps for the scores and everything. And it actually showed me that Sar was playing left centre back in the back three. And I was like, oh, surely not. But I think that's because the app is so default. Oh, yeah, Spurs are playing 3-4-3, 3-4-3, 3-4-3. That it just did that. And it just goes to show you how much of a state of a football club we're in. Because last week he said, this isn't tactical, it's individual errors. So he gives Sar a start and allows all those other people that have made the individual errors to carry on. And then when the shit hits the fan, he takes Sar off. Rather than one of the others that have made this mistake. That lineup, like you said, Perisic, I mean, those wingbacks were horrific. I mean, everyone, listen, no one gets away from this today. Every single player. Kane got his goal, but horrific. Kulusevski, you need to be dropped. You need to be dropped. The whole I'd start the youth team. I'd honestly start the youth team because at least they show a bit of fight and aggression and desire and passion. Hugo Lloris. Listen, there's loads of rumours coming out about why he didn't come out for the second half. It was an injury or he's had an argument.
He said in his interview he was injured.
Yeah, well, let's hope it's that or whatever. I don't want to see him in a Spurs shirt again this season. He's horrific. His confidence is gone. The whole team is horrific, but Fraser Foster needs to start. How many weeks have I been saying that with you guys on here? This is just a joke now. It's getting beyond the joke. The lineup. What can we do, Sim? What can we do? There's just nothing. There's just absolutely...
Was today evidence for you, Brian, as like why we haven't been seeing a back four this season?
Oh, without a shadow of a doubt. Without a shadow of a doubt. I mean, Romero was a disgrace as well today. Let's not pretend and just say, oh, because he's our best defender and he's won a World Cup, which someone said to me was a positive thing to look at Tottenham. We have a World Cup winner. I didn't know.
He was pretty much biting his nails for the whole game,
mate. The goal. Whose was it? I think it was Isaac's first, where Porro was playing him on side, and then Romero just let it go. It is a shambles. We can't play a back four. We can't play a back three. We are. And you know what? What I said in one of my tweets is, Daniel Levy had the fucking nerve to sack Martin Yo at half time. Well, let's see if you got the balls to sack Stellini this evening. or are you going to wait for him to resign to save a few more pennies?
What's the difference, Brian, if he sacks him now or if he leaves at the end of the season?
If he sacks him now and Mason takes charge, at least Mason will try and play attacking football. At least Mason.
We tried that today, didn't we?
No, no, Mason will try things. Mason will try. It's too late.
Stellini tried things today.
It's the mate. Yeah, when we're 3-0 down.
We don't have the players.
Listen, you know what I've said as well at the moment? Like I said, I don't care about the results. I don't care. This season, I don't care if we lose every game. I couldn't give a rat's arse, and I don't care if people come for me. I don't care. Europe's done. I don't give a shit. I don't care about results. Actually, I've been going on about the players. I don't care about the players. I don't care who signs a contract. I don't care who leaves. I don't care who comes in. I don't care who the manager is. Like I said last week, it can be the Jolly Green Giant or Captain Birdseye for all I fucking care. All I care about is the people at the top leaving this football club. That's all I care about. And until this happens, until people wake up, and I've seen the trust come out today going, this is really unacceptable. We can't do this. And this is unacceptable. Don't send an email. Don't send a letter. Go stand where I've been standing for 2.5 years, protesting and taking shit coming my way. Go and do something. Actions speak louder than words. I've been outside a training ground with Graham and Ryan from 6 a.m. for a month. There again in January. There every single home game with all the other people that do it and get pelters our way. But let's send an email or a strongly constructed letter, because that's had so much success. So much success at the moment. I am embarrassed. I am embarrassed today. Embarrassed. And all of us going on, and me included, going on about Arsenal bottling it. People in glass houses shouldn't throw stones. People in glass houses shouldn't throw stones, because believe me, it's coming back to us tenfold, and we deserve every single bit of it.
For Brian, 5-0 down after 20 minutes today. Have you ever seen anything like that first 20 minutes?
Do you know what? Today? And I'm so happy for one thing. My two nephews, or the eldest nephews, Isaac and Noah, came to want to watch the game with me. Thank God they were on either side of me, because if they weren't there, I think things would have got broken around this house, and I had to keep my calm. I'm trying to talk to them. Like I said, this is where we've got to now. Your parents and grandpa and other people watching this show, they've been told by their parents, their grandparents, their uncles, their cousins, the great 61 team, 51 team, the trophy winning teams, the double winning team. All these great, wonderful moments. My nephews, who have just turned 11, are getting really into football now and asking all the questions. What the hell can I tell them? We all support Spurs. It comes down the ranks through family and whatever. That's a given. But I lived by when my grandpa, his eyes lit up and the smile on his face, talking about the 61 double team and the phenomenal players and the style of play and the trophies we won and how people fear Tottenham. What am I going to tell Isaac and Noah and the others? But don't worry, we have NFL and two pitches. Come along. We have a record goal scorer that has won absolutely nothing. Come along, come on down. Support this team. How are we going to keep
the only thing you can tell him, Brian? It's not about the glory. It's not about the football. It's not about any of that. It's just about being in the depressing times all together and sticking together. That's about it.
Yeah, but this is the thing, mate. There is no sticking together. There is
me
no
and you
sticking
will stick together.
Together,
Brian.
Mate, always. But you know what I mean. This fan base has to. I mean, like I said, I don't really care what you think of me. Or what you think of the other Levy outers. If you're going to stand back and accept this and don't use your voice in the stadium or on social media or come and protest, because I've been saying it for years and it's like, oh, wait a minute, maybe this guy did have a point. If you're cutting your nose off to spite your face, then what are you doing? What are you doing? This club is being destroyed. Block by block, brick by brick, And we've got to do something about this. Fan power worked with Sugar. Like I said, people doubting it. This week alone, we've got into The Guardian, we've got into The Sun. Everything's getting out there. How much more are you willing to take of this? United are going to come to us Thursday and be screaming Glazers out. Glazers out. After probably being in an FA Cup final, winning a Carabao Cup, probably qualifying for the Champions League, yet they're still protesting against the owners. They bring in Erik ten Hag and spend £90 million on Antony, however much million on Martinez and all the other players they bring in. Cristiano Ronaldo causes shit. What do? The biggest money-spinning player in world football next to Messi. Oh, he's brought the club into disrepute? Bang, off you go. We won't worry about the money. Manager says out, he's out. But we'll just sit here, carry along. Now, Thursday, it best be toxic in there. It best be toxic. And all those fans that are going, Maurizio Pochettino, he's going to Chelsea. Now what are you going to do? Now what are you going to sing?
Yeah, talking about the hierarchy, Brian, like the excuse, I guess, before now, since Conte has been sacked, is like, you know, with Paratici, his future uncertain, you know, they haven't been able to kind of act in terms of getting a new manager and getting the ball rolling. Now that's dealt with, and with Spurs going as they are, surely they have to pull their finger out and start doing things now when it comes to getting a new manager, getting director of football. Like, there is no excuse for it taking any more time anymore.
Simeon, you know what we've become? These managers now, we're kind of like Watford, but just not as prolific. A manager looks at us now and says, there's no pressure to win anything, none whatsoever. All I need to do is have a top four race and try and get top four, and I'll get a new contract. Actually, only Poch has ever got a contract extension with these good businessmen. And if I don't fulfill the top four, I'll get sacked and walk away with that £15 million. That's the only way we get these managers now. We have to pay them an extortionate amount of money to come because they know they're not going to be backed. And they just sit here and go, do you know what? If I stay for 18 months and don't get top four, and I say something about the players, because we can't say anything about these players, if you hurt their feelings, then the manager has to go. And then they walk off with a payoff. When Bill Nick was here, you had an argument with Bill Nick, only one winner, Bill Nick. Alex Ferguson had an argument with the player. Didn't matter how big that player was or commercially how much money they brought in, like Beckham. Off you go. Off you go. The manager has spoken. Who in their right mind is going to come here?
And the same happens to any big club. You know, the same will happen to Arsenal. The same will happen to Manchester United. The same would happen to any big club. You know, if any player brings the club into disrepute, they are out the door. Out the door.
Ben, look at it. Mikel Arteta, his first managerial job. Aubameyang, Ozil, 350 grand a week players. They're bad eggs. Off you plop. Off you go. Forget that we've just given them new contracts. Forget the money they're costing us. You're the manager. We're going to stick by you, listen to you. Off you fuck.
Brian, tell me one other club, that has to convince managers to come here. Usually it's managers trying to convince the club to hire them. We're the ones that have to keep trying to convince these managers to come here. I mean, there's something seriously, seriously, seriously wrong here.
Yep. Daniel Philip Levy. Always comes back to this man. Now, like I said, and I've said it a billion times, once those players cross the white line, the result and the performance has absolutely nothing to do with Daniel Levy. However, the very fact that they're allowed to put on that white shirt, or in this case, blue shirt, and cross that line and play that on that play those games has everything to do with him. Mate, do you know the stupidest stat? Do you remember when this will make everyone laugh and show how absolutely pathetic this man is? When we lost to Newcastle 5-1, when we finished third in a two-horse race, not one Newcastle player that played today is in that team or squad. When we lost 5-1, five of those players are still at this club. Five.
Who but are those five? We've got Son, Kane, Lloris, Dyer Sanchez.
Oh, not Sanchez.
Dyer. No. Sanchez was there.
No, he wasn't there. He wasn't there when we lost 5-1. Who else would have been there? Yeah, I'm sure. Sanchez
came in the year after, didn't he?
Yeah, year after. I don't know who the other one
was. Well, they did mention the five, but this is how bad it is. You look at Arsenal when they showed this thing.
Davis.
There you go.
Oh, Ben Davis.
And you hear the breaking news? The breaking news yesterday, he's leaving the club.
Who, Lucas?
That's
yeah.
really breaking. Breaking about a year and a half ago. But yeah, there were five players there. Ben Davis as well, as Ariane said. Was it Ben Davies?
Yeah, Ben Davies.
There we go. So there we go. But there's five of them. Not a single one at Newcastle, but that's all right. We'll have the same five players from that season we came. This club is pathetic. They're disgusting. They disgust me. This club absolutely fucking right now disgusts me.
Brian, what do you think that Levy said to the players after the game, if he's right that he's gone to the dressing room?
You've cost me money. That's all he's done. Why has he not stormed in any other game? Now it's an embarrassment, and Newcastle have done. And then when we lose to Manchester United on Thursday and they're 9 points clear of us with two games in hand, you've cost me money and now we have to play in the Europa League. You may not get bonus. Mate, everything is money with this man. He should have been doing that all goddamn season, saying, what the hell are you doing? But nope, the second it becomes money orientated and Champions League, you guys didn't think it. I didn't think it for a while. As soon as top four is pretty much, like, in his eyes now done, let me go and tell the players how I feel. Do you know what? Piss off to Cambridge and do another interview and tell everyone how you feel. Come out and address the bloody fans. Apologise to the fans around the world that have had to get up late or get early, or people in this country watch this shit, and the fans that have travelled, come out and apologise to them. Come out and do something. Have some bottle and do something. But he won't, but he can storm in and have a work. I don't care if it takes me my dying breath. Until this man has gone, this is going to carry on. Because Kane now will be asking serious questions. Serious questions.
If he wasn't already.
We are in the biggest mess. And we have got to do something. We have got to. And on Thursday, I'm sorry, Levy out has got to be chanted as loud as possible for as long as possible. And anything Levy out orientated. He has got to know that this is unacceptable and no longer do we tolerate this crap.
Agreed. Brian, thanks for coming on today, my friend.
No problem. And as always, more than goddamn ever, Levy out.